friend Sue. And we're here to tell you a little bit about some of our solutions.
Yeah, I love solutions.
Because every once in a while, Earl, we have some problems.
We do have problems sometimes.
And we have to try to solve them. And so the solution I wanted to talk about today is...
getting a timer!
That's the one! Yay! Once upon a time, my friend Earl was using a writer at school. He was writing his name.
Practicing my name! E-A-R-L, my name!
He was drawing pictures, and it looked like loads of fun. And so, first I tried this. I'm going to have a turn and I think get
so.
Solution called use a timer. And so I said, Earl.
Yes, sir.
What about you play now?
Uh-huh.
And then I'll set a timer. And when the timer's done, it'll be my turn.
So I still get a little more time to play?
Yes.
Oh.
Are you okay with that?
I think that would work. Then I could get it back again after you do a timer?
Yeah. Let me grab a timer.
Okay.
And I'll set it. There's some. Solve a problem. See, I don't get it yet.
No, I'm still finished.
I still have to wait for the sand to come down. But once the sand comes down, I'm going to pretend like it did. Once the sand comes down, I could say, hey, Earl, the timer's done.
Okay.
Now it's my turn.
Great. There you go, Sue.
Oh, thanks. And then I would be able to use the writer. Hey, that's a great solution. Yes. You could try that at home sometime.
Yeah, because that's a great way to take turns.
Yeah.
And now we're both happy.
My mom has a timer on the stove. Does your dad have a timer on his phone?
He does.
Perfect. Great ways to solve solutions at home. Well,
yes.
Bye for now. We better go.
See you later.